So at the beginning of the year, I just was thinking about how overwhelming wellness has gotten. There's endless podcasts. The Manosphere podcasts are just like telling you so many different things every week to do. There's businesses where you can spend like $7,000 a month where you go and you get, you know, go get tested for all this stuff every month. And you get AI to tell you what to eat and what to exercise. It just feels very overwhelming. And I thought, okay, what's the response to that? What is my response to that? I want to cheat. I want a cheat code. I want an easy way out. I want a hack. And so we got the whole Pursuit team together to think, to like go out and do research and figure out what are like the hot wellness hacks right now that makes it easier for you. Because at the end of the day, what you really need to do is exercise, you need to sleep, you need to talk to people, and you need to eat well. That's basically all you need to do. So like, what are the things that can sort of hack your way into doing those more easily? And so as I was doing my research, I discovered the Katalyst suit, which is an EMS suit. It's a stim suit like you, physical therapists use after you get an injury. They kind of zap your muscles with electricity, and it encourages your muscles to work harder. More of it tenses up, and then it heals stronger. And so that technology is now a suit that you can wear, and you can do workouts, and it like supercharges your workouts.
Okay, I know the guy who owns the company is sitting right here, but I'm still going to put you on the spot, Chris, because yes. I see technology like this, and I'm like,
yeah,
does it actually work?
I have to tell you, it actually works.
You're
I
mean, not just saying that because Brandon is sitting here.
You can't see my bulging muscles through my blazer.
But you're serious.
But it really totally works. I did it for 6 months after having a pair of injuries. I had foot surgery. You guys remember I fractured my elbow.
I do.
I was like out of the gym for months. I felt kind of bummed about it. And it really got me back going. You really see results. It helped my posture. I lost weight, gained muscle.
All right, so Brendan, come on in. You are the owner of Katalyst. Talk to us about this device, kind of how it came to be, and tell us a little bit about the business.
Yeah, so I joined EMS about 4 years ago, and I was a little skeptical at first, too. My wife had used it about 7 years ago.
Actually, EMS is electrical muscle stimulation.
Exactly. Okay. And just like a doctor or a physical therapist will put stim on you to heal a muscle, it's the same type of technology. And doctors have been using it for 60 years. If you go to Europe, there are EMS studios where there's thousands of them where people will go in and work out. I went in skeptically and tried it about 4 years ago during COVID, and it's amazing. For me, it compresses time. I can get a two-hour workout that would normally take me 2 hours in a gym, I can do it in 20 minutes. And it's a whole body workout. It hits the little muscles in your back that you might miss in the gym or skip leg day. It's your whole body, 26 pads at once, and it stimulates your muscle. Just like your brain sends a signal to your muscle to contract, the suit sends the same muscles, the same signals, and it hits 90% of your muscles. And so it's amazing. And it works. It's efficient. It's fast. It's safe. And it compresses time for me.
So you were a client.
I was
and
a client.
Then you became an investor, and now you're the owner.
Yes, it's something I'm really passionate about. I use it 3 days a week, so 20 minutes each time, basically an hour a week. That little prep, little cleanup, but compared to changing and driving to a gym and working out for 2 hours, I can do it in 20 minutes. I can do it at home. I travel with it. It's spectacular.
All right. So, what does it cost?
So the suit retails for $3,000. There's an app. And there's trainers on the app, so you pick. I want to focus on strength. I want to focus on cardio.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm going to focus on my lower legs or my abs. I'm 50 years old. I've worked out in gyms for 40 years. This is the first I've done Ironman. I've done marathons. I've done every kind of fitness activity you can do. I'm very active. This is the first time I have abs at 53. Right? Like, it's never happened before, and it's all because of the suit. I can turn up the abs. And hit those muscles. $3,000. You follow a trainer on the app, and that person leads you through a 20-minute workout.
People might know you from your days in cannabis, medical cannabis specifically. You were one of the co-founders of Tilray. You led the company. It's publicly traded now. You're no longer involved in cannabis. What was the process that got you to buying Katalyst? And talk a little bit about the challenges the company's had before you came on board and what you're trying to do now to get it away from those challenges.
Absolutely. So I think cannabis, I started in cannabis back in 2011. So 14 years ago. And back then, people thought it was crazy, right? Like, what is he doing? He went to Yale. He has an MBA. Why is he going into cannabis? And he's throwing away his whole career. But I could see the future, right? I could see what was going to happen. I knew that country after country was going to legalize, and U.S. states were going to legalize. And so I saw the opportunity. I saw what was going to happen. I see the same thing in EMS. If you go to Europe, there's these studios everywhere with people working out in suits. And I think 5 years from now, everyone in the U.S. will be familiar with EMS. They'll either have a suit or they'll go to a gym and work out in that suit because it's the future of fitness.
Well, Chris, I mean, you do cover so much about wellness and fitness. We talk about it with you all the time. I mean, how do you slot this in? What are you hearing kind of from maybe the industry about maybe is this kind of a next wave?
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely, we've done stories about EMS suits before. Plastic surgeons in New York City offer it. There's some startups that offer sort of similar things where you go to a studio. For me, this really fit into my normal system of going to Barry's Bootcamp. You know, I'm a big Barry's person, and doing my normal weightlifts. And then I added this in, two or three times a week, 20 minutes. And that's where it really supercharged everything else that I did. And especially on a day when, you know, like Brendan said, if you're too busy or you're traveling or whatever, you can just kind of toss it in. And although I have not taken it on a plane before, so I brought it with me. So this is what it looks like.
Is it heavy?
Quite big. It's not. Not really.
Okay. So for those listening on radio, Chris is holding up the vest portion, but there's also that sort of, there's another portion.
So it goes all the way down.
Yes.
That's
it
for
goes
your,
around your legs and your chest. Legs.
Vest and legs.
Okay,
and there's
vest
arms,
and legs.
There are armbands that go with it, and you have to get it wet for the stim pads to like really work.
But you have to do that with a heart rate monitor too. It's kind of the same thing, right?
Exactly. Okay. Yeah. Very similar.
So Brent, what do you see as your market? Is it a case of selling directly to consumers? Is it about setting up places like the Peloton model to some extent where you could go and actually get on a Peloton and be at a physical location? I mean, Peloton kind of went back and forth. Like, what's the model in terms of growing this business?
So right now, there are thousands of consumers that own the suit and they work out at their homes or at the office or in their hotel rooms while they're traveling. And they work out with the app. There are also maybe 200 to 300 studios in the U.S. that use a suit. Many of them use the Katalyst suit. And so you can go to an EMS studio if you're mostly in a big city and try it. And so they use the Katalyst suit. And so it's both supplying to studios, and we're seeing more and more of those open, and then also to consumers.
What's the moat that you have here? Because if this is big in Europe, you're doing it here in the U.S., people might catch on, they might see that it's working. Copycats could come in. What separates you? How do you protect the brand?
I think there's two moats. I think the first moat is, an EMS suit is regulated like a toaster in Europe. and so manufacturers can just make them and sell them.
Yeah.
Here it's regulated by the FDA. And so this suit is FDA cleared. Uh-huh. And so we went through the FDA process in order to sell it to consumers. That's one moat. I think the second moat is the content. There's hundreds of workouts online that you can engage in. The app actually is what sends the impulses to the suit.
That's what zaps you. And so, the app zaps you.
Yes. And so the app does it.
It's, wait, can it's I use this to my family on, to get them
off.
To do other things? Yeah. Just I saying. No, forgive me. Go ahead.
No, I think it's the content and the FDA clearance are really the two moats.
What about competition or just the wellness world at large? Like, it feels like, you know, we go through these fads and waves and trends.
Yeah, you don't want this to end up in the same pile as the Thighmaster.
I think that...
Hey,
that
everybody should have a Thighmaster. No, I'm just kidding. No, but how do you make sure?
Like, I think strength is important no matter what you do, right? And so I use my suit 3 days a week, 20 minutes. I run. So I have cardio. You can, you know, work out on a treadmill wearing the suit. People do that. But I think strength will always be there. Strength will always be important. It fixes your posture. Bone density for a lot of people is really important. People on GLP-1 drugs lose strength. And so this suit helps people of different demographics and ages.
Very quickly, you can work out while you're wearing the suit and also wear the suit independently while you're not working out, or you're always working out while you wear it.
There are people that do freestyle workouts, which means the suit is charging, impulsing, and they're folding laundry or doing the dishes or walking on a treadmill.